guys, today it's here, Trish back again to make another video at the Urologic Center. And we have Anurag. And so yeah, let's go.
We'll get a knowledge about that also. This is the blood flow and this is the heparin. Heparin, okay. That will use to prevent the clot, okay, in the blood.
Okay.
Due to the circulation blood flow, right?
Okay.
That's all. This is the heparin. Heparin values. You have to go.
So guys, we're here at the NephroSafe Dialysis Center. And behind me, I have a dialysis machine over here. I'm going to start out by talking about the hemodialysis chart. This thing has all the details of the patients which come inside the hospital. It has their name, their age, their sex, their diagnosis, why they're getting diagnosed here. They have a weight quantifier which tells us their weight before the dialysis, and it tells us the weight after the dialysis. After this, they measure how much weight gain they've done, and they, according to that, they set their ultrafiltration target. And behind the sheet, we have the consent chart. This consent chart contains if there's any issues with the patient going on. The consent chart says it's not their fault anymore, so, and that's what the consent chart's about. Then we come to the dialysis machine, which is why we've come to the dialysis center. As you can see, the entire dialysis machine is big and right next to the patient's bed. So we'll start out with the bicarbs and the acetate patients. These bicarb bottles are connected with the dialysis machine. After all of this is done, we take the dialysis tube and we attach it with the dialysis machine. After this is attached with the machine, the dialyzer is put on the side and is attached with the tubes, which is then attached with the couplings behind the machine over there. Yeah, the bicarbs and the acetates are also attached over there. After all of this is done, there are the syringes, which are then placed over here, which supply heparin to the patient through these syringes. This is a 10 mm syringe, as you can see. After all of this is done, we take a liquid known as NS, which is then attached and suspended from a tall metal container. After this is done, this helps in cleaning the tubes present over here. So just in case of any chemicals, to check the flow if the tube is, you know, it's still working. And after all of this is done, they use the Rena zone, which contains spirit and cotton, which is used to clean the fistula. And when this is done cleaning, fistula needles or tubes are attached with the arm. And there are two types. There's a 17 gauge fistula needle and there's a 16 gauge fistula needle. The 17 gauge is a smaller one and the 16 gauge is the bigger one. After all of this is done, it is attached with the pump present over here. The dialysis begins from here. It starts pumping all the blood from the tube to the filter, which filters all the blood and then sends it back. And as you can see, this is for the venous and these are for the arteries. The blood comes in from the arteries and is filtered through the dialyzer and is sent back through the venous to the body. And that's how you dialyze blood. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. Another dialysis center is the stairs here. Now we're going to head back home to finish the project. We learned pretty interesting stuff about the dialyzer, dialysis machine, how the patient, yeah, how it works. What do you have to say, Anurag? You didn't even talk the entire project.
Well, it was kind of confusing, but we did learn a lot.
Yeah, it was pretty confusing.
Yes.
The staff over there were really helpful. Thanks to them, we learned lots about the machine. And do we even know where we're going? Where are we going? Okay, As you can see, we had to learn a lot about the machine through the previous video you just saw. And yeah, now we're heading back home to finish the project. The bio project, Anurag's going home. Bye, Anurag. And yeah, that was the end of our project. I hope you liked it. And